Hello everyone, this is Mirzai from Cal Poly Pomona, and in this lecture, I'm going to explain the concept of R-square in regression. So typically, one of the criteria that helps us to understand if we have a good regression model is R-square. We look at the value of R-square and we say the higher it is, the better the model is in terms of capturing the error of the prediction. But how this value is calculated? Despite all the typical videos that you watch and they walk you over the formula, this time I'm not going to talk about the equations and how we calculate it. I'm actually going to walk you through some steps and help you to understand the fundamental meaning of R-square and how the formula has been set up in the first place. So before we start calculating the R-square and understanding its meaning, we need to have a regression model. Suppose that we are trying to predict time based on miles. In Excel, it's very easy to set up a simple linear regression model using the scatter plot. If you go under Insert, under the charts, the first one is the scatter chart. If you select that, it automatically generates a chart, which is not really the representative of the X and Y that you're looking into. What you can do if you right-click on the plot area, it allows you to select your data and adjust your X and Y axis. So it says your data range is from A to C51. I'm going to change that to B because my data starts from B1 all the way to C51 because these are the two corners of the rectangular shape that selects the data. So if I do that, and then when I click on the name is time, which is good. If I hit on x-axis, you see the miles is selected for my x-axis, which is fine. And if I hit on y, you see time is selected for my y-axis. So x is miles and y is times because you're trying to predict time based on miles. If I hit OK, it adjusts my chart. Now I see a reasonable graph. Now if you right-click in one of the points, so if you like pick one of these points and then right-click on it, there's an option called Add Trendline. If you click that, then you're going to be able to set up a regression model over this data. So by default is on linear model, I'm going to leave the default setup as it is. And the only thing I want to add, I want to see the equation of the line. In addition, I want to see the R-squared because I want to show you how we can actually get to this number by following some steps. So this is the equation of the line. Basically, the idea of regression model is that we use this line, the point in this line, to predict the actual value of time. For example, if you travel 80 miles, we predict that it's going to take you this much time, whatever is on this line, to travel the 80 miles. But in reality, the numbers have been 7.2, 8.2, 8.7 hours, and 8.9 hours. So what I estimate using this equation, I give you a number that is not one of the actual values. So I have some error in my prediction. And this error is going to be the amount that we are interested to know, because for any of these points that happen in reality, we are using the point on this regression line. If I want to travel, for example, 55 miles, I put the 55 miles instead of x in this equation and calculate the travel time. So let's calculate that. So it's going to be 0.0753 multiplied by the miles traveled plus 2.2077. So that would be the equation for my line, and I can name this column regression estimation. The regression estimation for this number of miles traveled is 6.3, but in reality, it took us 8.8, so we have some error. So I can calculate the error of this prediction, which is equal to the difference between these two, but we typically represent the error in terms of a squared value because we don't want the positive and negative terms in error cancel each other. So that's going to be the squared of the error. So I can add S at the beginning of error so I know that it's a squared error. Now I can populate this formula for the 50 rows that I have. The easiest way to populate this formula is when you select these two columns. If you go to the bottom right of this rectangular shape, you see a plus sign. If you double click on the plus sign, it populates all the formulas for the 50 rows that you have. Now, easily, you have calculated all your estimation using the regression model and all the value of errors. So what I want you to do next is calculate the summation of all these errors. So I'm going to calculate the summation of all these errors And if I do that, the summation is 116.78. Now, the next experiment that we want to do is to do not use the regression model. So this time, what I want you to do is to assume that we're not using the regression model. Suppose that your estimation for the time for the trip is simply the average of all the times. So if I look at the average of the time, I'm going to add that here, average. A lot of time we use average of something as an approximation. So if I look at the average here, it's 7.76. So what if I use simple average as an estimate of the time of the trip? So what happens is that you're just looking at this 0.7.76 as the estimation of your travel time instead of the regression model. So which one do you think is a better estimation? Just looking at the pure average or using this regress line here, this equation? That's the question that we want to answer using R-squared. Basically, R-squared tells you how much your error is going to improve when you go from a simple average estimation to a more sophisticated regression model. So to be able to see how much error improvement we have to calculate error in that case too. So I put average estimation, and I assume that for all the travel time, we use the average travel time, which is 7.76, as the estimation. So I'm going to refer to the cell that contains the average, but we have to make it fixed so it doesn't change as we drag the formula. So fix it, you can use function and F4. So if you hit F4 in a PC or function F4 in a Mac, you can fix the cell. Now go to the lower right and double click on the plus sign. If I just refer to cell C52 and I don't fix it, then when I try to copy the formula down, it shows me zero because next it goes to C53. Next time goes to C54. If you want to avoid that, you have to hit function F4 to add dollar signs before and after the column name, and that way it's fixed. Now if I populate it, it goes all the way through. Now I have the average as my estimation all the way through. I want to calculate the error in this case, how much error I have in comparison with the actual value. So again, you're going to calculate the squared of the error. So this time you're going to have 8.8 minus 7.762. That is the squared. So this becomes my error for this case. Now, if I look at the summation of the errors, so this is populated for row 52, which is not right. So I delete those numbers and I want to calculate the summation of this column. If I look at the summation, now I have 211. 211 is the sum square of error when I use average as my estimation, and 116 is my error, sum square of error, when I use regression model. So this sum square is called sum square of error, and this one is called sum square of total. So sum square of total is nothing but the sum square of error when you use average as your estimation. Sum square of error is when you use regression as the basis of your time estimation. Sum square of regression is the difference between these two because it shows how much your regression is going to improve the error in your model. So that becomes the sum square of regression. You probably have seen the formula for calculation of these, but this is just experimentally showing you what these equations are, and you can develop your equations from here. Now, what is R-squared? R-squared is basically shows you what is the percentage of error improvement going from the average estimation to using your regression model. How much did we improve? This is the amount of improvement. But what is the percentage of improvement? This is the definition of your R-squared, basically. Percentage improvement in error when you're using regression model as opposed to your average. So how much did we improve the difference between these two, which we call sum square of regression? And the percentage of improvement is this, the ratio of this over the total amount, which is 0.44. If you multiply that by 100, then you get 44.71%, which is exactly the same thing that we had here. You see that? So R squared shows you how much your error has improved or basically decreased by going from a simple average estimation to using this equation or this line as the estimation of your data. So now if I want to write the formula for, let's say, sum square of total, would be the summation of xi minus x bar that are squared. So that's the definition of the equation that you have, because every time each xi minus the actual average gives you this term, and you sum over them and you calculate the sum square of total. So that would become the sum square of total that you probably have seen in design of experiment and the context of regression and so forth. Now, what is the sum square of error? Sum square of error is going to be the summation of xi minus, this time we use y hat, which is our approximation using the regression model. So I call it y hat because that's what's typically used, y hat I. So this time you have the summation of each observation minus the y hat, which is the equation of the regression line. And each of these error terms is squared, and in the end you sum them up. And what is the sum square of regression? It's going to be the difference between these two, sum square of total minus sum square of error, gives you the sum square of regression. So that was our R squared, and the equation for R squared is going to be SSR divided by SST. With that, our lesson is concluded. Please refer to your Blackboard for your assignments. Thank you.